for now, it's USB and drivers for the PC. Mostly we are taking care about the Windows solution. With the Linux, we don't have such experience. Regularly, we are not working with Linux. But most of the time, the solutions are even working better with Linux. So, on the Microsoft, there are so-called kernel drivers, which you can recognize by the .sys. And to create and develop and maintain such driver, it's a really hard work. You need to have access to the Windows developers file and really a lot of experience. So this is something we never tried. So that's the reason why we intend to use the standard class, which already have these drivers from the Windows. So if you expected here that we will tell you anything about creation of this kind of driver, unfortunately not. We only know it's a very extensive job. You also need to test on multiple platforms, verify this test, and it's hard work. So for this purpose, we all the time use only the standard classes, which already have this driver inside of the system. So for example, the virtual comport, also this chapter is here mainly to the virtual comport, because it's the CDC which needs the driver, and mainly the signature for the driver and the information file for the driver. For other classes, we don't need to solve any issues in this way, because they are enumerated and enumerated automatically and connected automatically to the system. So only the VCP, which is using so-called USB cert.sys in the from Windows XP till Windows 8. In Windows 10 it's already different. We need to solve this situation. For the mass storage and HID, there is no need to handle the drivers. With the HID, there is the drawback that you need to be aware about the descriptor report. So the mix of the strange numbers, which is quite hard to study. So that's are the drivers. Then very interested options are the WinUSB or the LibUSB. The WinUSB, as the name can give you the clue, is the set of the possible drivers for the Windows. So it's not platform independent, but at the end you again need the signature for this kind of driver if you intend to use it. And it's useful if you want to somehow improve or change the overall functionality. So if the virtual comport interface is not the convenient for you, you can change it, change the use endpoint, change the send data, and then use some of the drivers. So for example, the WinUSB or the LibUSB, through this driver connect to the application, and inside of the application handle according to your needs. But the message is still the same. You need to sign the driver for both of them. With Linux, we have the experience only with the libUSB. I tried once to create the same for Windows and for the Linux. Using the libUSB, I was able to work on both platform. This is one of the hands-ons we were not able to fit into our schedule, so you have it on your flash sticks, also with the terminal. You are free to use later on. So now we are using the sys drivers, but for the virtual comport, this driver demands to be connected with your device, and the system. So for this purpose, there are so-called information in files, so informative file, which are describing the device, so product ID, vendor ID, use interface, and some other information. And at the end, also the string information. And at the end, this information file is pointing to the driver which shall be used. We are here discussing the VCP problem. So at the end, it's showing it's pointing to USB ser.sys, the kernel driver which is already inside of the Windows operating system. So using this file, you are able to more or less assign the driver to your device, but the Windows demands to have the signature of the driver. So the user then can be sure that the functionality is verified and it should not harm his computer. So even if you don't sign the driver, you are able to use the virtual COM port with different product ID, vendor ID, and without the signature. But it's possible only on the Windows 7, on the Windows 8. It's possible only if you change the setting inside of the BIOS or the bootloader. So for the development purpose, this is possible, but at the end you cannot release it without the signature because it doesn't look good, and I cannot imagine that anyone would like to use unknown driver from unknown vendor, and it's not a standard option. So for this purpose you need also create a so-called cat file, which is holding the information about the kernel driver, and the important thing is the signature. So the system driver itself, so the kernel driver, and quite the usual feature of this is the installation file, so the .exe file which will install these drivers with the information to the PC. You were able to see it, for example, when you were installing the ST-Link utility, so the driver to ST-Link, then it's there for the DFU, and the same is true if you are installing only the standalone driver for virtual COM port or in general any other kind of drivers. So the signature is needed. That's also the reason why I show you before the custom HID. So there are some limitations, but you don't need to take care about the driver and about the signature for the driver. So VCP, most used interface for data communication between the USB host and device in the embedded environment. The reason is the simplicity that I believe almost every programming language have already the interface for the virtual COM port, and there is a lot of terminal application, so it's still used. So from it was Windows 9.10 till Windows 10, there was the USB ser.sys, so the driver where you need to get the signature, but inside of the Windows 10 you don't need any driver signature anymore. Only condition you need to fulfill is the correct device descriptor, so the class and subclass need to have the correct shape. This change is implemented inside QPMX and QPMX repository 2 years or something like that. So for the new project, 2 years, so it's quite a long time. It's enumerated and working in Windows 10 without any problem, but Windows 7 and the older system still take a great part of the market share, so you also need to handle the driver for older system. So one possibility is to use some other driver already signed by some other parties. So as you can see, all our examples with the virtual COM port have the same product ID, vendor ID, We have the infile already also signed. So this is used in our application. A lot of times we get the request, can we use ST product ID, vendor ID for virtual COM port inside our application? Are we violating something? So the answer is yes, you can use it. But we cannot give you any official document, any official letter that you are allowed, but we can promise you for sure that nobody will chase you for this. What is the drawback? That if you use the ST signed in file, there are the ST strings, so it's ST microelectronics virtual COM port, and you are not able to change it. Inside of your application, inside of the descriptor, there is the string where you can write whatever you want, but in the Windows is displayed the string from the int file where is ST microelectronics, and if you change it, the signature is not valid anymore. So you can use it, but every time you use it, you will see ST microelectronics. So if you want to use with your own string, you need to obtain your own product and vendor ID combination and sign the driver. So disadvantages of the virtual COM port, I think we already mentioned a few times. So it's not there's the lack of native plug and play support. Additional endpoint which you may then miss if you are creating some composite device, and the driver. So what we are, so then you choose to create your own device. You don't like to see the ST credentials, so you get your product vendor ID. I will talk about it a bit later on. And now you need to get the signature for your driver. So we try in our team, so my boss passed the signature process. It took him like 1 month, so it's quite a harder job, and I will talk about this a bit later. So there are two kinds of the signature you can get. So the first one is code signing certificate, and the second one is with the extended validity. The difference between these two is the price. So the first one is cheaper, and you don't need to fulfill so many conditions, so it's easier to get. But what you cannot do with the code signing certificate is to drive the kernel mode drivers. So if we create, and we don't want to create any kernel driver, we cannot sign. So with this, we can sign the software for the Windows, but our purpose is to sign the int file for the Windows, which we tried and succeed, so no red Windows anymore. What we are not yet sure is the expiration. Now we have it for 1 year, so we will see what happens then, but we expect that it will be easily transformed if we pay. And that's not so huge problem. I think at the end the total cost was $100 per 1 year. So the extended validity, you can also sign some more things, but we don't need it, and the timestamps not crucial for us right now. So we tried and succeeded to get the code signing certificate. There are some links where to look. So the list of the signature authorities, so which company can help you, which company can provide you the signature, so you can contact them. At the end, we choose the DigiCert. I think the reason is quite obvious, it was the cheapest. So with the DigiCert, we get the signature for 1 year. And how was the procedure? So first, he needs to get the letter and sign it. And the sign of the letter needs to be verified. So my boss entered a notary in Czech Republic. He verified the signature. But the DigiCert is in the US, and also the other signing companies were in US, and they need the official translation of the verification of the signature. So he needs to go to the some Ministry of the Interior for official translation of the signature. And there is only one place. Fortunately, it's in Prague, so the same place we are also located to get it. But it's bureaucracy. The opening hours are not intended for regular people. So, if as you are in Italy, and if you will be able to get some Italian company, it can be great advantage. If you get the company from US, you will need to get through the same procedure. So. You will get the official letter, you need to sign it, you need to get the verification from the notary on your sign, and official translation. After that, there was a Skype call with the DigiCert, and we obtained the keys. So we need to get the secure storage for the private key and distribute the public key. And in total, it takes 1 month, but if we would be pushing harder, it could be in 1 week. And now, a lot of people is asking, so they are quite loaded, so hard to say what is their response time now. But this experience is limited on one attempt with one company, but before we had no experience, so at least now we have something we can share, and hopefully it will be somehow usable for you. So now, we have here some quick guidance. If you obtain your signature and get some modified in file, how to sign. So again, there is a link here. And I'm thinking if you will be able to get it outside of the PDF. That's a good note. And after that, you need to install and go through the various settings from Windows. There is a complete package provided by the Windows, so the Windows driver kit. And using this kit and following the README and so on, some try fails during 3 hours, we were able to sign our in file. So here are also some examples how we made it also for various platforms, so for various types of window. So probably not so interested now, but for later on it can be interested guidance. So at the end we get a driver which can be published and used without any problem. In the signature you will see Ivo Císař as a name, so that's the one who did it. Now, another interesting topic is the product ID, vendor ID. If you create some new device, the device should have unique combination of these two numbers, but theoretically for each type of device, this should be unique, but you cannot just made it up, because afterwards it could lead to the confusion with the drivers. So these combinations are checked by the USB organization. So you have to obtain first your combination before you are able to use it. I believe it's also connected to the signature afterward, but not sure about it right now. So first option is to obtain your own vendor ID which give you the full address range of 16 bit for the products, and you can do whatever you want with this range. But the membership cost $4,000 per year, and it's additional $5,000 when you enter the organization. You get some additional advantages, like you can go for the conference, but who cares if you want to product just 100 pieces. So for this, we are offering that we will assign you some product ID out of ST vendor ID range. So upon a request, either you can contact your local FAE, or you can contact directly us on the support. We will ask you for some more information we are putting into the tables. So at the end, you get first the more or less official mail from ST that this product ID is assigned to your name, your product, and you are free to use with some other condition. I will talk about it. And once per quarter, these requests are taken and sent to the USB organization, so it's propagated to their database. So we are giving up these product IDs for free. So whoever write us, I would like to get one or two, so some reasonable number, not I need 1,000 product IDs. We will generate for him. So for to support the developers with the ST. What are the drawbacks? As you are not the vendor, you are not allowed to use the USB mark on the device, but the connector is explaining everything. So if you take a look on your mouse, on your flash stick, there is no USB mark. On the PC you are able to see it, but for example with the flash stick, I haven't met yet the flash stick with the USB mark. It's clear enough that it's USB device. So that's only the drawback, and the second is the optical that your vendor ID is the ST one. But the savings can be really significant. Okay, so this is how it's go. We are filling this formula, so the details about the company name, name of the responsible people, that we are fitting there, and at the end of the quarter you get the official letter from, or the official mail from USB organization.